objects which they see need not be real. That is the idea. Just because you see, it is not real. Just because you see in the dream state some objects, that is not real. Just because you see in the waking state snake is not real. Similarly, just because you see the glass, the cup, that need not be real. In fact, that is not real. That is the idea here.
Faptul că vedem un obiect, asta nu conferă caracterul de realitate și de obiect. Numai prin simplu fapt că îl vedem, dacă îl percepem, nu înseamnă că el este real.
Okay, so in this, what happened is, we are negating. Okay, I have negated two things now. I have negated the objects in front of me because it has form. Everything is form. I have negated them. Under this body sense organ comes. This body also. Because it is form. Whatever is form is not real. Just be it you or be it this body itself. It's not real. Okay? Now. Because what? It is illusory because it is seen. The seen undergoes transformation. That which undergoes transformation cannot be real. The logic that yesterday that is real and today this is real is stupid. You cannot say that is real yesterday, this is the reality today. Because truth does not change. Truth does not change. It is same for yesterday, same for today, same for tomorrow. Real truth does not undergo any change. Now you see this.
Ceea ce vedem este iluzoriu și pentru faptul că îl vedem. Deci pentru faptul că este un obiect al observației, al percepției noastre, el capătă acest caracter iluzoriu. Da? Și suferă transformări. Da? Și acesta este un alt atribut al iluzoriului. Da? Transformarea ține de sfera a ceea ce este iluzoriu. Iar adevărul nu suferă transformări niciodată. Da?
So, we have negated the body in front of me and this body itself. Okay. Now, with this, we are negating two different atmas. There are different atmas. What is atma? What do you mean by atma? Atma is not self. In Sanskrit, atma, though is loosely translated as self, it is not self. Anything can be atma. Anything. This paper can be Atma, this cup can be Atma, this cloth can be Atma. At that very point, whatever you refer to is Atma. That is why studying Vedanta under a guru is a must. Because the Vedas use this so loosely. It says Atma. Atma means sense organ. Atma. Atma need not be self. Atma may be the spot. Atma may not be myself. Atma may be my son, my wife. We do say, this is me. I am this person. When someone comes to our house and we want that person to be treated as you yourself are, you say, I and he are not different. Okay? Serving the same way. I and he are not different. We are identifying with another person. Okay? So, here also, we are negating the two different atmas. First, we understand what atma is. Atma can mean anything. So, now we are negating two different atmas. That I'll explain first.
Aici negăm două tipuri de... Am negat obiectele, am negat corpul, negăm două tipuri de atma. Mai întâi este, trebuie să înțelegem conceptul de atma. Da? Atma nu înseamnă doar sinele, nu face referire doar la sine. Da? Atma poate să fie absolut orice. Poate să fie această cutie, poate să fie această cană, poate să fie absolut orice. De aceea este nevoie de un maestru pentru a clarifica aceste concepte cu claritate.
Ok. So... Normally when we say Atma, we say One is a Paramatma, the other is a Jivatma. These are the two classifications under which we explain. One is Param, means absolute, Paramatma. The other is a Jivatma. Jiva self, individual self. Param, absolute. Atma, self, absolute self, individual self. Okay? This is a general classification. Even in the Jivatma, there are different classifications. One is this body. This is Jivatma. Identifying with someone, that body, that also is Jivatma. We say, when we love an object or somebody, we say, this is me. How can you destroy this? How can you disrespect this? So, it can be an object or body. Okay? So, Atma, if this body is Atma, this is called as Mithyatma, illusory self. This body is a Mithyatma, illusory self. Okay? The other body, other objects, they are Gaunatma, secondary self. They are non-important self. Objects, body or whatever it may be, they are Gaunatma, means a non-important self or secondary self. This body is a Mithyatma, means a illusory self. There is other self, which is a the main self. Okay?
Cardinal pentru Atma este Paratma și Jivatma. Paratma se referă la sinele absolut, Jivatma la sinele individual. Și aici există iarăși mai multe clasificări. Dacă vorbim despre corp, Atma, vorbim despre Nityatma și acesta este sinele iluzoriu. Și de Gaunatma. Gaunatma. Sunt celelalte obiecte și acesta este sinele secundar sau neimportant.
Ok. So, we have Mithyatma body, Gaunatma.
Gauna.
Gauna. Ok. Gaunatma means the other non-important things which we give importance. We see it as ourself. So, now, with this, Rupam Drishyam Lochanam Drik, form is a seen, I, the sense organ, is the seer. With this, we have negated two things. One, the other objects, accepting other objects as self. We have negated a Gaunatma. Not just that, we have negated this Mithyatma. Gaunatma, the secondary self. Mithyatma, this body. Illusory self. So, we have negated both because both are seen, perceived. Therefore, we are negating. Both are forms. Therefore, we are negating both.
Această sintagmă, obiectele sunt percepute de către ochi, da? Am negat, le-am negat pe amândouă, pe cele două, da? Atât corpul, cât și obiectele. Am negat atât Mithyatma, cât și Gaunatma, da? Pentru că ele fiind percepute, da, sunt iluzorii. Le-am negat pe amândouă. Ele sunt forme, sunt percepute, sunt văzute, pot fi văzute.
So, this negates the school of thought, it's a philosophy again, which says the body is the self. The materialistic people, they accept the body to be self. That is negated. Why? Because that is seen. Form is seen. Therefore, that is not the seer. That which undergoes change cannot be seer. That which is changeless is the seer. So, we have negated the bodies. And we accept the sense organ. Sense organ is in the body or not? Yes. So, So it is as well negated. No, we are seeing. The vision is not dependent upon the body. In the dream state, we see that. It is not dependent upon the body. But still, the objects are created. That's why I brought in the dream. In the dream, the sense organ is there and the sense objects are there. It is not dependent upon your body. Because you say, I traveled in my dream. Where did you travel? You traveled somewhere. Where did you travel? Out of body experience. How did it happen? It's all imagined. So, this I, this sense organ is not dependent upon the body. Okay? Let us here have it like that.
Acest argument este un argument esențial pentru a contracara argumentele școlii materialiste care spune că spun, această școală spune că afirmă, susține că sinele este corpul fizic. Da? Deci acest argument prin care am negat obiectele și corpul, Chiatma și Raună Katma, este argumentul esențial pentru a contracara această filozofie materialistă.
So, the negation, I am doing the negation. How long can you negate? Only till the substratum. That is the rule here. Okay? I have negated the external and my own body. Now, I am going to negate that which sees these things. Because it is also that which undergoes transformation. If it undergoes transformation, if it undergoes change, it cannot be real. But my eyes don't undergo any transformation. Right? No, not right. You were having 6 bar 6. Now, what? E. Okay. Oh, that's C. I'm sorry, 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 C. Whether it is C or E, we don't know without our specs. So, it undergoes transformation. That which changes cannot be real. Rule number one. That which changes cannot be real. So, now we see this. Andhyamandhyapatutveshu Netrudharuneshu chekadha Sankalpayet manashrotra Tvagadau yojyatamidam Andhyamandhyapatutveshu Andhya, Mandhya, Patutveshu. Netra Dharmeshu. Cha Ekadha. Cha Ekadha is a Cha Ekadha. Sankalpayet Manaha. Cha Ekadha. Sankalpayet Manaha. Shrotra. Tvagado yojyatam idam. Shrotra tvagado yojyatam idam. Okay. Andhya. Andhya means blindness. Mandhya means dullness. Patutva means sharpness. In the eye is blind. I don't see. I see not properly. And I see very clearly. These states exist. Andhya, Mandhya, Patutva. Blind, not proper, perfect. So, Eshu. Eshu, Shu is a plural. Okay, seventh case plural. So, in this, Netra Dharmeshu. What are these? Netra Dharmeshu. Dharma, attribute. Attribute of what? Netra, eyes. The attribute of eyes. In these that are attribute of eyes, the good power, no power or very perfect power, improper power. So all these, cha ekadha sankalpet, all these are seen of one category, are experienced as one category by mind. What kind of category it is? What type does the mind sees? These perfect, non-perfect or blindness, etc. as a object. Krishya. Seen. I am blind. It is seen by the mind. I am perfect. That is also seen by mind. Vision is perfect. That is also seen by mind. My vision is not perfect, imperfect. That is all seen by mind. Cha ekadha. So mana sankalpayat manadi mind experiences in this way. We have to extrapolate the same thing. Shrotra twagado. Shrotra means hearing, ears. Twag means the sense organ of touch, etc. Ado. In the other sense organs also, yojyatam idam, you have to extrapolate the same idea. Whatever you understand with reference to the eyes, you have to see in the other sense organs also.
Așadar, până când, până unde mergem cu negația, până unde ajungem cu negația, la unul am negat obiectele, am negat corpul, dar până unde mergem cu negația, mergem cu negația până ajungem la ceea ce este real, la substrat. Da? Pentru că atâta vreme cât ceva ne suferă transformări la obiectele, și corpul și mai departe, atâta vreme cât ele suferă transformări, atunci nu sunt reale și atunci vom nega. Ne vom nega până când ajungem la substrat. Trecem mai departe la strofa a treia și ea are următorul înțeles. Orbirea sau vederea imperfectă, vederea perfectă, toate acestea, da, sunt atribute ale ochiului și ele sunt percepute de minte ca fiind o singură categorie, aceea de obiecte. Da? Tot astfel, prin extensie, aplicăm această logică și la celelalte organe de simț.
So, she given the paper. You have the paper, Shloka?
Da.
Have that in front of close this book. Listen. This is Shravana, listening. Okay? Listen. She can read Sanskrit. The only person in this room who can read Sanskrit, other than me. Okay, so now, what is this? The mind is the seer and the sense organs are seen. How? Because the sense organs expertise, non-expertise or absence of the power, all of them are seen by the mind. Okay? All the sense organs. Now here, this is the question, okay. Therefore, we understand what the sense organs are not the seer, the mind is the seer. This is the idea here, okay.
Dar, indiferent de capacitățile lor, de atributele lor, organele de simț reprezintă un obiect pentru minte. Trebuie să înțelegem claritate că organele de simț sunt obiectul percepției pentru minte și mintea este cea care le percepe, vede.
Okay. The sense organ is one and it sees the different states. Therefore, the varied states cannot be real. That which is one, which is changeless, is the real. Now, I come to the eye. I think eye is the sense organ is the real. But sense organ is a Andhya, Mandhya, Patu. Sense organ have these different states. It changes. That which changes cannot be the self. That which undergoes change cannot be the self. That which undergoes transformation cannot be the self. Therefore, it is also non-self.
Obiectele se schimbă, se transformă și deci ele nu pot fi reale și nu pot fi simele. Mergem mai departe, ajungem la organele de simț, la fel am văzut că prezintă diverse stări, diverse atribute, se transformă și deci ele nu pot fi reale și nu pot fi simele, pentru că se transformă.
Ok. So, the mind exists, the sense organ exists. The mind does not exist, the sense organ does not exist. Is this true? The mind exists, the sense organ exists. The mind does not exist, the sense organ does not exist. Is this true? Is this true? Yes.
Yes.
How? Because I am sitting in the class, I am daydreaming. Though my sense organs are perfect, I don't see or hear anything. Therefore, okay, you people are listening, therefore, your mind is established. It is established now. Okay, good. So, the sense organ is dependent upon the existence of mind. The sense organs are not independent, they are dependent on the mind. If the mind is wandering somewhere, I don't see. This is our experience. And the Shruti also exactly states this. Anyatra mana abhuvam. The Shruti says, Anyatra mana abhuvam. My mind was somewhere else. So, I don't see. I didn't hear. What are you saying? So, that is the reason we say, see the paper, not the book. Okay. Close. Okay, now explain that.
Organele de simț sunt dependente de minte. Dacă mintea nu există, nici ele nu există. Și dăm un exemplu simplu. Stăm în clasă și mintea mă îndărăște în altă parte și nu vedem și nu auzim nimic din ce se întâmplă în clasă. Nu auzim nimic din ce se întâmplă în clasă. La fel și Shruti spune că mintea mea era în altă parte. Există o afirmație, o expresie, o propoziție. Deci, organele de simț sunt dependente de minte.
You are sounding like there is a cracker, you know, which is bound together, 100 crackers. You burn the wick and then everything stops. Suddenly after 10 minutes, pop! So like that, she was suddenly stops and then suddenly. Okay. So this is the third state. What is the third state? The sense organs are not self because they undergo change. That which undergo change cannot be the self. Then now we have to find that self. So he says, next, what is that? Kama sankalpa dehado. Kama sankalpa sandeho. Shraddha shraddhe dhrutitare. Kreerdhirdhirityevam adibhasayatye kathachitihi kamaha sankalpaha sandeha sandeho sankalpa sandeho shraddha ashraddhe dhruti itare kreerdhirdhir iti evam adir bhasayati ekathachitihi. This is one mantra which we have heard a lot of times. Kama sankalpa vichikita ashraddha ashraddha aditi aditi kreer dheer bheer iti etat sarvam mana eva. Brihadaranyaka Upanishad states that all these different transformations which the mind undergoes, they are nothing but a mind. All the thought functions are nothing but mind. Therefore, we deduce mind is nothing but a thought function. All these thought functions are mind. That means mind is a thought function. Mind does not have any different existence other than thought function. That is why we cannot say where the mind is. I can say my eyes are here. When everywhere, this is the game which the elders play with the child. Okay. Where is your eye? Okay. Where is the ear? Okay. Everywhere this is the game. Now, you say, where is the mind? I don't know. You cannot? Yeah, it's somewhere outside. That is also possible. So, we cannot point out to the place where the mind exists. Why? Because it is not gross.
Ajungem la strofa numărul 4. În Brihadaranyaka Upanishad spune că toate modificările mentale sunt doar minte. Mintea, de aici ducem mintea, este modificare mentală. De aceea nu putem să indicăm locul în care se află mintea. Nu putem să precizăm unde este mintea. Aici, ca în cazul, dăm un exemplu, cum un copil este întrebat de adunț unde e urechea aici, unde e ochiul aici, putem indica, da? Dar în cazul minții nu putem să indicăm locul în care aceasta se află, pentru că nu este ceva grosier.
Okay. So, in the previous third shloka, the people who accept the sense organs to be real, the sense organs or the prana to be real, they are negator. People who accept the sense organ and the prana to be the, to be real, they are negator. Just say that and we'll go.
Am văzut că în, în strofa anterioară, acele persoane, e vorba despre materialiști care consideră că corpul este real și prana este reală, acest punct de vedere a fost negat în versetul, în strofa anterioară.
Ok. Sense organ is negated as non-real. Fine. Prana, how can I add that prana? It's not said anywhere. Prana is not real. But I added prana also. Why? Because the sense organs gain strength only through the prana. If there is no prana, if there is no prana, your sense organ loses its strength. Don't eat for 2 days. After that, when I ask you to sit in the Vedanta class, I say, Atma, what? What? You will not be able to hear. Where is Guruji? You will be looking. I am in front of you, but you will be looking. Because your eyes will not be seeing properly. Because the strength which the prana gives to the sense organs, they are lacking. Prana is not there, the sense organ don't function. Therefore, prana and sense organ, both are negated as not self.
Atât prana cât și organele de simț sunt negate ca fiind ideale, nu sunt sinele. De ce am adus în discuție și conceptul de prana? Pentru că nu a fost menționat în text. Am adus în discuție pentru că organele de simț își iau puterea de la energie, de la prana, da? Dacă nu există prana, organele de simț nu funcționează corespunzător. Dacă nu mâncăm pentru câteva zile, venim în clasă și nu putem să vedem lucrurile, nu vedem pe gruji, nu putem percepe lucrurile, datorită faptului că în lipsa pranei, organele de simț nu funcționează corespunzător. De aceea le-am legat amândouă, strâns legate, au legătură.
So, in the dreams, in the deep sleep state, the mind does not exist. Therefore, the vision does not, the sense organ don't exist. In the dream state, the mind exists. Therefore, the sense organ does not exist. In the dream state, the mind does not exist. Therefore, the sense organ does not exist there. Okay? Say this. We'll go to the...
Starea de somn profund fără vise, mintea nu există, organele de simț nu există, da, concomitența aceea. În starea de somn cu vise, mintea există, și organele simți dău, parcă există.
Ok. So, kamaha. Kamaha means desire. With respect to the objects. Desire. Kamaha. Sankalpa. Sankalpa sandeha. There are two words. That's why it's given in dual case. Sankalpa sandeha. There are two words. Okay. Sankalpa sandeha. Sankalpa means conclusion, determination. Sandeha, conclusion or determination, sankalpa. Sandeha means doubt. Sandeha means doubt. Okay, first desire, then determination, then doubt. Shraddha, shraddha, faith. Ashraddha, lack of faith. Lack of faith, absence of faith. Dhruti, dhruti means strength. Dhruti, strength. Adhruti, weakness. Kreer, kreer means shyness. Shyness, kreer, shyness. Shy, being shy. Yes, shy, shyness. Okay. Then, dhi means intelligent. Intelligence. Bhi means fear.